The 2010 college baseball season for the University of Connecticut was an exciting time of growth and transition as the Huskies and head coach Jim Penders took their game and the program to the national stage. The Huskies shattered the school's all-time single-season win record with 48 victories, including a stunning school record 22-game regular season winning streak that included 14 consecutive wins in the Big East Conference.
It's very difficult to win, you know, three or four games in a row in baseball, let alone 22. You know, we were just playing at a very high level for an awfully long time, over a month. And it just, you know, got to the point where we just believed that nobody could beat us. And there's just so much failure inherent in the game that you've got to have such a mental edge in order to compete, especially at a high level in the Big East Conference. And I can honestly say this year was the first year that when I arrived at the ballpark, I felt like the better team was in my dugout every single time. We hope to feel an awful lot more of that in 2011 and beyond. And I think now in the summertime, you look back and say, that was pretty darn special. And we're hearing a lot from a lot of my colleagues on the road, a lot of our coaching colleagues saying, you know, it was unbelievable, you know, to just see you guys, it was like a flywheel. It just wouldn't stop, you know, it just kept going and going and going. And you have a little bit more perspective and can appreciate exactly what the guys accomplished.
As UConn kept adding to its win column during the regular season and into postseason play, the national media were talking UConn baseball, ranking the Huskies as high as number 13 in the nation.
We've got the resources. We have the support. The fact that we had 6,000 people show up at Dodd Stadium in Norwich, you know, basically with 4 or 5 days notice, I think speaks volumes of the potential of our program. We want to schedule excellence, so we're trying to upgrade our program, and we certainly want to play the best of the best wherever they are because we expect to be better each and every year. We've seen a really big impact. I didn't realize the impact that the top 25 really would have. This summer's been fantastic with the response that we've gotten on the recruiting trail. Just to be able to say, hey, you're now talking to the University of Connecticut, which is one of the top 25 public institutions in the country. And, oh, by the way, we also happen to have a top 25 baseball program now. And I think that's been incredibly powerful. It's gotten us a lot of notice and certainly generated an awful lot of interest from players within the state and even from outside the region.
With the Huskies' 48 wins during a busy 64-game schedule in 2010, UConn is rising to a national level along with its competition in the Big East as it becomes one of the top conferences in the country and the biggest conference on the Division I level.
Every Division I program in New England that we play on a regular basis, we've got a winning record over, dating back to 1896. And so we've always, I felt, you know, when I played here, we were the regional power. And now the challenge, I think, is, okay, now you're in the Big East. The Big East is no longer just a New England or Northeast conference. You know, we've got powers from outside the region. You know, University of South Florida, Notre Dame, West Virginia, Louisville. Teams from outside our region that have come in and really kind of raised the bar. Competitively, I think, on a national level. And now we've got to break through and be one of the top programs in the Big East. And I think we're in the midst of accomplishing that. I think it's you're never done. You got to keep climbing and keep grabbing for that next brass ring. But I think we're getting to a point where we're going to compete, you know, for a Big East championship every single year. And if we don't, that's going to be a very disappointing season. In essence, if you're competing for a Big East championship every year, you are, you know, you do have a chance to win in Omaha. You are competing for a national championship. That's the caliber of the league now.
The UConn baseball program is not only producing team and individual success, including head coach Jim Penders, who was named Big East Conference, New England Region, and ECAC Coach of the Year, but Husky standouts are now being drafted and signed by major league clubs, excelling in collegiate summer leagues and representing their country as part of the USA national team. Other accolades go to ABCA NCAA All-American first baseman Mike Nemeth for a career record of 237 hits and junior third baseman Mike Olt for a career 44 home runs.
Well, we tell the guys a rising tide raises all ships. And, you know, if you can have success as a team, it's only going to get you that much more interest as an individual. George Springer and Matt Barnes right now are half a world away, you know, representing the University of Connecticut and the state of Connecticut. And our program on an international stage. It's that's pretty darn cool. And so it's been neat to see those guys kind of carry the banner of UConn really all over the world this summer. I can't follow them each and every day, but you get to see Joe Pavone make the Cape Cod Baseball League All-Star team, you know, and have an extraordinary summer. And Nick Ahmed's done very well out there in the summer. All of those individual accomplishments are really a byproduct, I think, of the team chemistry that we had, the team successes that we had. They came out of, you know, an awful lot of wins. I think that's going to have an impact, certainly on their lives, and I think it's also going to be, you know, a big impact on our programs.
The success of the 2010 season is rooted in the belief by Coach Penders that UConn baseball is about much more than just wins on the diamond.
We basically build the entire foundation of the program on these four pillars, and the first one is graduation. We're here to educate young men, help them get to where they're going. They've got to graduate with a bachelor's degree and excel, reach their academic potential in doing so. The second one's also very easily measured, and that's competing for championships, winning championships. We want to be in a position to do that every single year. I think we're in that position now as a program, and this place demands nothing but that. The third one isn't as easily measured, but I think everybody knows it when they see it, and that's the creation of leadership. It's our job as coaches to get the most out of them and to basically make sure that they're more accountable, more dependable, more caring, more self-disciplined than when they got to us. And the way we measure that is the fourth pillar. If they're giving back and want to be a part of perpetuating, you know, the program and what they learn there, maybe coaching, maybe bringing what we've helped them learn to youth. Everything that we do is built on those four pillars. You can be doing something every day to get better, and that's what we preach to our guys. We want them to have the best attitude, concentration, and effort they can possibly have at everything that they do. And that goes on 12 months a year, and that's the reality of competing for championships in college baseball nowadays. There's really no time off.
The elevation of a Northeast powerhouse program to the national stage in 2010 was fully in focus when the NCAA Baseball Committee awarded UConn with a host designation for the NCAA Regionals at Dodge Stadium in Norwich.
What a great opportunity we had, and I think I think it was very well received. I think the people of the state of Connecticut should be congratulated, and the people of New England that are college baseball fans or just baseball fans in general that showed up and jam the streets of Norwich to get there. I've heard from hundreds of people that said they were there, and I'll probably hear from thousands over the course of the next, you know, 10, 15, 20 years that claim to have been there. But it was pretty neat to look up from the third base coach's box and not see a seat that was unoccupied. And you know, I think it speaks volumes for not only the potential of Northeast baseball, but for the potential of our program in particular.
Connecticut baseball has a long-standing, proud tradition of success that includes five trips to the College Baseball World Series in Omaha, Nebraska. Jim Penders has set his sights on returning to that World Series stage as he maps out UConn's short and long-term goals.
I tell every recruit that I sit with that I dream of coaching in Omaha. And I dream of doing so with Connecticut across my chest. When you host a regional, when you're named as one of the top 16 teams hunting for Omaha in a publication and all that stuff, that's nice, but it's not gonna win us one single game in 2011. Our preparation, our attention to detail, our attitude, our concentration, our effort, those are the things that are gonna help us win games. And that's what we really need our current players focusing on. But we do like the fact that we're getting some attention, and we want to push that to people maybe outside the program that didn't expect that or haven't expected it in the past. It's certainly possible here. We were five wins away from playing in Omaha this year. So, you know, a couple bounces, a couple breaks. We work a little bit harder. We work a little bit better next year. Anything's possible.
Connecticut, baby, let's go.
We've been sweating a whole lot long just to get this right. It's a work hard hit, hard struggle, it's a sacrifice. It's says I.